Hello student, myself Sheikh Amir. Here I am a research analyst in a crime management. Here I am for Indian Polity. Okay, I will be mentioning basically how to approach for Indian Polity. Before starting with the subject, I will give you some brief idea what's the demand of the UPSC while preparing for Indian Polity from last 3 years, 4 years. Still we could not able to crack this examination. There is some dilemma, there is some crux I will be sharing with you. First of all, today I will teach you brief overview of what exactly the subject is all about. How to approach for Indian Polity. I can tell you, even an IAS officer's teaching cannot make you an next IAS officer until and unless you are clear with these thing called approach. What is approach? Means your strategy. Because only reading Lakshmikant or NCRT couldn't able to get you in the service. What you want is perfect strategy. You can see a last 10 years topper. They are not so with a very brilliant mind. They are very highly qualified people. They are very normal grad students who are topping this examination. And why not only IITs or doctors are making into the list? Why? Because their approach is very much clear. That is strategy. Strategy here means a demand of examination. What is the demand of the examination? We will see. We will ask directly to the UPSC, what is your demand? The UPSC say in the form of syllabus. This is a main Bible of your subject, syllabus. Then next, whereby you can know exact demand of the examination is question paper analysis. I can give you a four mantra whereby you can get into the list, not only get into the list, but you can crack this examination with very flowering marks. So what I can say here, first point is syllabus. Syllabus is the core of this examination because people are reading Lakshmikant, NCRT very thoroughly, but they don't know what exactly the demand, that is syllabus. Syllabus, the first line of your syllabus says Indian historical background of Indian constitution, their amendment, their basic features. The first line, try to adhere to the demand of syllabus first. Question paper analysis. From 2013, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Before starting with the subject, know what is the difference between 2013 paper, 2014. Why the UPSC is asking so question in 2013 and why not 2014? If you know the difference behind this, you can easily make into the list that what examiner want. Because you are from day one, they don't check how much knowledge only you have, how much flowery language you use. What they see in you, an act of administrator is there or not. Until and unless you have this thing called administration in your each and every, whether you're writing science and technology, whether you are approaching for Indian Polity, any subject, if you're an act of an administrator is not there, you won't be able to crack this examination. So first of all, I give you a approach. First is syllabus, second is question paper analysis, precise and concise note, not reading each and every book, what all you have to read in Indian polity. Is NCERT 11th, 12th, Lakshmikant, Pradhan Mantri report, episode, Samvidhan, episode. These are the four things. This is called static. Only reading your NCERT, Lakshmikant, Pradhan Mantri report or Samvidhan episode, you won't be again couldn't able to solve. I think so. You can only solve a static portion of this examination. But you won't be able to crack it in this examination until and unless you know one thing called current affairs. The combination, what your examiner asks in your examination is static plus current affair. Now, current affairs is what is happening in current scenario. That is, you will be reading from The Hindu, GK Today and the magazine and so on. How to read a current affair, that is another topic. I'm here to give you a brief overview of Indian polity. So now, before starting with the subject, you know approach. First is analyze what you want to do, that is syllabus, question paper analysis, and collect your precise note. That is your clear with approach, Indian polity. Now, before starting with the subject, you should know what is meant by polity. Why UPSC have inculcated this subject in your paper? Without polity also we can become administrator. If why not, right? Why UPSC have inculcated this? Always try to put this syllable in each and every thing. Why you are reading Indian polity, why and how you are analyzing your subject. If you know why you are reading, you will get an idea that is how to read and what not to read. Until and unless you are not aware with this why, your study will be in the vague condition. So before starting with the subject, let's see what is polity. Polity means, it's in a word derived from the Greek which says citizenship or government. Now, polity means in short and a government. What exactly government? With this word only, we can analyze that this subject will mainly concern about government and its structure. What government, which structure, which rules and regulation, we will see mainly in this subject. If you see the lining of your syllabus, first line of your syllabus says, Indian Constitution, historical underpinning, evolution, features, amendment, significant provision and basic structure. Mainly they are talking about these three things only. In your Indian polity, this is the main crux of your subject. Government, structure and rules and regulation. The first line, if you see, Indian Constitution, rules and regulation, structure, the government. Second line, if you see, function, responsibility of the union and the state, issues and
challenges
issues of pertaining to federal structure, devolution of power, finance up to local level, and challenges therein, and so on. Mainly, if you analyze your thing in your subject, they mainly talk about government structure and rules and regulation. We are aware the word with called polity. Polity mainly means government and citizenship. Now, we are aware with now what is polity. Now we will jump to what is constitution. What is the need of constitution? And what are the function of constitution? Now, mainly as we see here, like polity deal with three: government structure and rules and regulation. Now, what is mean by constitution? In very basic line, constitution means set of rules and regulation to govern the country. Now, what is mean by rules and what is mean by regulation? If you understand this, you can easily write function of your constitution and what is a need and what is a challenge in making the constitution. You will get easily first when you know what is rules and what is regulation. Rules is your laws that government makes. Regulation means guidelines that how to run this law. Mainly your constitution talks about sets of rules and regulation to govern the country. Govern means kisi cheez ko chalana, to take the control and run the country. Mainly your governing means to take the control of the body and run the organization. So mainly your constitution talks about rules, regulation and the govern. So now, what is constitution? You know basic idea like a rules regulation of particular country to go. Now, what is memorandum of association? Memorandum of association is terms and condition which is there for company. Now, what is the terms and condition? That is nothing but memorandum of association is a constitution of company. And to govern the country, we need a constitution. Indian, what we call Samvidhan in Hindi, this is a rules and regulation for our country, and memorandum of association is for company. If you understand this principle, this is your constitution. Your sets of rules and regulation. Any law, if you make bill, a triple talaq bill, bill, a woman issue of Sabarimala, bill, a Hindu code bill, any bill with respect to territory or citizen of India, it should be within the boundaries of this constitution, what we call a Lakshman Rekha, to make the law. Any this constitution sets a limit for administrator for controlling the activity or making the rules and regulation within the framework of the constitution. If you exceed this circle, if you exceed the Lakshman Rekha or boundaries, that act is called unlawful, void in nature. Why? Because this is a supreme law of a country. You are crossing that boundary, that means you are making an unlawful activity, unlawful act, or void in nature. Now we exactly know what is constitution here. Without rules and regulation also we can run the organization. Yes, if you see like that, without constitution, without reading Indian polity also, we can read, without reading Indian polity, we can crack examination, if it's so. Without constitution also, we can run our country. If so, what will happen? What is a constitution? We will see the roles of constitution, how constitution play important role in setting up a country. The roles here, mainly your constitution is a limit and a boundaries and a terms and condition for two parties. One is for people, one is for government. What government? One. Your government is divided into three parameters: legislative, executive, and judiciary. What legislative? Always ask why you, if you want to remember that concept for a longer run. Legislative. This body, this part of the government make laws. Executive. This part of the body enforce the law. Judiciary will interpret the law. For example, Aadhaar bill, if government make the rules and regulation, make the laws with pertaining to Aadhaar bill, and executive part will enforce the bill, aage chalayega, and what the these part, judiciary will interpret. What is mean by interpretation? Interpretation here means government is making right law and running the law in right way. What judiciary will see? That government will is running the right law, or and government is functioning that law in right way or not. If that violate any single thing, what already we need, judiciary will mainly take care that any law that government makes, it should be within the boundaries or within the framework of the constitution. If we, this part cross the boundaries of the constitution, that judiciary will put a stay, put a activity called a void, put a act that, for example, triple talaq bill, government pass easily, execute properly. Interpretation, there was a PIL that certain sect of really part of the minority says that their integrity, their right to religion is violated. Unka kehna tha ki their fundamental right, that is right to religion, is challenged. So what they have said that the judiciary, they put PIL in the judiciary, in Supreme Court, that our law is violated, our right have been snatched. So they mainly what they had done, they filed the PIL. Now what Supreme Court do, what judiciary department will do, they will see that is PIL is valid. If that is valid, if their complaint is valid, what the judiciary will do, judiciary will ask these part of the government to mold, to what to do, to mold the laws or bill. This mold is called interpretation. The main work of judiciary is interpretation of law. And what judiciary will make? They will put whichever act is going beyond the boundaries of the constitution, will try to bring again back in this circle called sets of rules and regulation of particular country. Now what we exactly know, what is constitution here? Now you know what all the role the constitution is playing. First role is between the as a government and with respect to people, to providing, and constitution sets of rules and regulation is not for the people. Patrick Henry rightly said that constitution is not to restrain the people but to restrain the government. It's rightly marked by the Patrick Henry, so that government perform their function. What function? Their legislative function, their executive function, their judiciary function within the framework of constitution. It's these function, these constitution put limits on government so that our country don't become like North Korea, Kim Jong-un, authoritative rule, one man rule. Our country is democratically elected. Mainly what we have studied, what is constitution, what are the role that this constitution is playing, and now we will see mainly what are the function, why we need function and need of the constitution, why we need constitution in today's world. Without constitution also we can run, but exactly it's not the same as we in the functions. While reading all the rules and regulation of the constitution, what we have seen that it's important to bind the government, to put a certain limit so that the government couldn't make any hectic law, any unlawful law, so that country look like authoritative country. It should look like democratic country. Demo means people, kratic means rule. Rule by people. To mold this principle, to inculcate this principle of the constitution, we need a certain rules and regulations so that it bind and it take care of all the laws, all the situation that the government is doing. So mainly your polity talks about government structure and rules and regulations. So mainly we are watching here a third part, that is rules and regulation. What rules and regulation? In terms of constitution, what role they have played? Mainly two roles, as a government and for the people. What constitution will see? That the right of the people is not violative in nature. They take care of the people and sets a limit for the government. next part, what is a need of the constitution here? Last topic for the day. What is the need of the constitution? First point, to govern the people. Second point, so that we maintain accurate political system in country. To protect interest of the people. Need of your constitution is to govern the people, to have the democratic political system in India, to protect the interest of larger interest of people, so that people feel safe and not like authority country, for example North Korea. So what all we have read today is what exactly means constitution, what role played by the constitution, and what is a need of constitution. This is a main part that is very basic. Terms that we are clear with: constitution, roles played by the constitution, and need of the constitution, that is need for your clearing your Indian politics. So main part of, if you see in your syllabus, that is historical underpinning of constitution. So what historical, the background of the constitution they are asking in your examination. So today we are only done with only minute part, that is called constitution, roles played, and need of the constitution. Okay, thank you so much for